Now, first of all, what is a cucumber? What is a cucumber? Any idea? No idea. What, madam? No idea about cucumber? Can I show that picture? Then you can get some idea. Oh, this is cucumber like that. Not framework, madam. This is cucumber. What, madam? Now you can get idea cucumber? Yeah, that just I'm asking what is a cucumber, but you are telling no idea. So everyone knows about that cucumber, yes or no? Hello? Yes. So if I'm asking about what is the cucumber framework means, okay, then we don't have some idea, so that is one of the framework. Maybe we can use it in the Selenium, or we can use it in Ruby on Rails, Pico container, Spring framework, somewhere else we can use it. So normally what is that cucumber? Cucumber is one of the tool. So in Selenium we have multiple frameworks are there. Modular framework, data driven framework, keyword driven framework, hybrid framework, multiples are there. But cucumber is one of the BDD framework. So what is that BDD? Behavior driven development. So this is one of the behavior driven development framework, which is used to write the acceptance test for web applications. Here we can write acceptance test for web applications. So generally up to now we are following test design driven framework, test driven development framework. Why? Because in case of test driven development, it will be execute a particular piece of code only. So whatever the program I am written, that program only it will be executed. So that is called as test driven development. See, just now we have written the programs in Selenium. Log into the HMS, log out to the HMS. So only a piece of code will be executed. Only one function I need to check it by using test driven development. Whereas in case of the behavior driven development, we need to execute the entire system. We need to test the system rather than a testing of particular piece of code. So first of all, what is a behavior driven development? Nowadays, most of the organizations, while at the time of developing an application, parallelly, we need to implement the test scenarios and test scripts. But in normal Selenium, what are the scripts we are preparing? That is only understandable by the test engineer. Yes or no? Suppose if I am giving these scripts to my business analyst, he can get it, those scripts, BA people. No. Well, because as a tester, we have idea about those scripting language and everything. But at the time of real-time organization, business and IT don't always understand each other. Business analyst is the different, developer point of view different, test engineer point of view different. Each and every they have their own script. Business analyst always they gather data from the clients only. Developer they only the programming, test engineer they can get the code. So each and every person having different test script they can develop. But here what happened is there cucumber, behavior driven development is nothing but one common language we can use, which make easy to coordination between all these three members. Why? Because if any problem is raised, BA will be taking the different solution. developer will be thinking different, test engineer will be different. So there is no sometimes coordination missing between all these. Due to that reason, this framework will be given very, very helpful to maintain coordination between all the team members. It allows the test scripts to be written without any knowledge of the coding part. No problem. Any non-programmers also can write the programming in the behavior driven. Why? Because it is just like common English language. Yes, that is the common English language is there. There is one language is there, Gherkin language. So what is the language we are using here? Means Gherkin. This is the language we can use here. Why? Because in that some common keywords are there. Based on that keywords, we need to develop our script, which is commonly understandable to the BA, developer, or test engineer. That is the behavior driven. To maintain the coordination between these three members, this framework is very, very useful. Why? Because at the time of Selenium, if I'm writing the script, I can able to understand it. I can run it. If any problem is there, I can solve it. So the main purpose of Cucumber is it merges the specifications and test documentation. What is the main purpose of Cucumber? It will merge specifications and test documentation should be merged. So, due to that reason, nowadays Cucumber become very, very, very popular. So the main Cucumber will be act as a the bridge between the business analyst and the technical people. Why? Because we can write the test cases in some plain English language. So first two, initially the Cucumber was implemented in Ruby language. Yes, first initially implemented Ruby language. After that, it supports multiple languages, Ruby, Java, Groovy language, it supports all. It supports Ruby, it supports Java, it supports Groovy, it supports Gosu, this is another language, Lua, .NET, PHP, Python, multiple. So, you know, you can go, I am going for the Selenium with Cucumber with Java and Cucumber with Python also hot tip nowadays. So where we can use this Cucumber? I can use in Selenium, I can use there. And I can use in Ruby on Rails. This is one of the framework tool. We can use Pico container. Here I can use it. And I can use Spring framework. Multiple frameworks I can use this Cucumber. So the main advantage is the main whatever the automational functional validations are there, all those automational functionalities I can written in a some common language, understandable language to the BA, developer and test engineer. I can develop it. Here the main thing is Cucumber contains some files. Those files are called as feature files. Later on we will explain about this. What is the feature file? What it contains? The main, all the step-by-step execution procedure will be contained in our feature files only. So what is the feature file? What is the feature file? What it contains in the feature file? Suppose I need to go for one scenario, observe. Normal scenario. My scenario, suppose I purchase a mobile. I bought a mobile yesterday. Okay. So now, maybe I purchased some second hand mobile. Today, I can use it, then I don't want to use that. I want to return it. I want to refund. I want to refund my mobile and I want to collect the money. So yesterday I paid for the mobile 5000 rupees. Okay. So to refund the mobile, maybe it is my friend shop. Okay. So he will be refunded and I can get the money. So to refund the mobile, So what are the steps I need to follow here? What are the steps we need to follow? Hello? Are you speaking, Harsh?
No, sir.
Yeah. To refund the mobile, what we have to follow the steps? First of all, we should have the receipt.
You need to have receipt, you need to take it to the store.
Neha, tell me.
We need to have the receipt.
Yes, first we need to have the receipt. Without receipt, can I go there? They can accept it? No.
No.
So first customer should have their receipt. Okay, that is the first point. Excellent point. Now next. Next one.
You need to go to store and talk to the person, sales person.
Okay, we have to talk with some salesperson. Okay, this is also aggregated. I am given to that receipt and I hand out to the mobile and I can get back the money. These are all the oral step. Yes or no? Orally we are speaking.
Yeah.
But now what I am telling is, first of all, customer should have their receipts. Now, whenever you can purchase the mobile, then only they can have the receipt. Yes or no? Otherwise, if they have any dummy bill, by using the dummy bill, can I go to the any shop?
No,
not possible. So whenever customer has purchased one bill, then they can get the receipt. Then only they can get the receipt. Okay, in that customer, they have receipt also. Already he originally can purchase, so they can get their receipt. After that, once I can give this receipt to the salesperson, what is performing salesperson? The salesperson hand over the mobile and return money back to the customer. Means they are onlinely credited to my account. So the salesperson process of refund completed. Once I can get the money, what happened? What is the output? What we have to next one? Two things will happen here. Once I can hand over the mobile, once I can get the money, two things will happen. What is that? In the mobile shop, in their stock inventory, one mobile should be incremented. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Yes. Automatically in my account balance, 5000 amount should be incremented. That is also done. So once I can give a mobile to the customer, in their inventory, one mobile stock should be increased. As well as the customer, means my account, will be credited by 5000 rupees. Yes or no? This is we have to done normally. Yes. So now what is the main purpose I am taking here? Refund mobile means this is nothing but the process of refund. The process of refund. So when you can read this statement, what you have to understand? Okay, we have to something refund to something. So I don't know written all this. Okay. I am not written anything. Okay, now tell me, by seeing this, what you can understand refund process means? We should
scenario.
Refund. Yes or no? Yes?
No.
Refund process is nothing but we are refund something, whether it is a mobile, TV, whatever it is, something. We have to refund something, we need to tell that. So, whatever we need to add that is called as main is nothing but one feature file that is called as nothing but one specification I am given. So this refund procedure is nothing but a feature, is nothing but our specification. This is my requirement. In that requirement, what is the scenario? My scenario contains, so first of all, if I want to go to that, the customer should have received. Without any receipt, I can't do anything. Means that is called as your scenario. Scenario is nothing but what to test in the application. Same like that, customer should have the receipt. Otherwise, it is not possible to go to the shop and ask. Then, if I want to go to the shop and ask the person, we have precondition. The precondition is nothing but we should have received with me. Then only I can ask that. So that is called as given precondition. After that, whatever the process is going on there, means salesperson collected the mobile, given the money and everything. That is called as when. When salesperson completed my procedure, what is the final result? Then. So here, see, that is these are all the common words in the Gherkin language. Given, when, then. Given is nothing but one precondition. When is nothing but what to test in the application. Then is nothing but finally what is our output. Suppose you can see, I want to log into the functionality. Okay, regularly I am using the so many programs I have written Selenium. I want to log into the HMS. What we have to do? First, I need to open an URL. Selenium by Mahesh.com I can open. After that, go to the HMS. So, first I need to open an URL. So, what we have to check in here? I need to check that login functionality. So, what happened then? Now, my feature is I need to check login functionality. So here I am checking the login functionality. Now there are multiple scenarios are there. I need to check login functionality with valid data, maybe invalid data, maybe without data. Multiple possibilities are there. So what is my scenario? My first scenario is I need to check login functionality with valid data. So if I am writing like this, anyone, either it is a BA, either it is a developer, either a test engineer, anyone can understand. Okay, he is checking login functionality, that is one specification, is nothing but one feature. Scenario is nothing but what to test. I need to check that login functionality. First time I need to go to the with valid data. After that, given precondition. What is the precondition? When it will login? Whenever user provide username. So when I can provide username? First of all, he should be open an URL. Observe every time in the program, I can write open URL, login, logout. Every time open URL, open URL, open URL. That open URL is the precondition. The precondition is nothing but your given condition. So means what I am written here, user navigate to Selenium by mahesh.com/hms.com. This page. Okay, presently is under this page. Fine. Next, what we have to do? I need to perform some user actions, means enter username, enter password. First time I need to enter both valid and. So that is you can return in your when. So whenever user provides username as my username is user one. So first I need to check with the valid data and my password is user one. So when user logs with username as user one and password is user one. What is the output, madam? What is the output? Login should be successful. So this is called as one feature file. Common English language, I can write one scenario. So the feature, one feature is nothing but the main one specification. So in Cucumber, we have two files are there. One is feature file, one is test run file. Feature file contains all the English language anyone can understand it, either it is a BA or it is a test engineer or it is a developer. So each and every feature file contains the extension is .feature. So what is scenario? Scenario is nothing but what to test. What is the given? Given is nothing but a precondition to perform user any actions. Then is nothing but the output, the overcome of the output, or what is the result of that. So in that, how to write the scenarios? Why? Because it is just like one English language and there is no programming. Much programming is not there. Once we go to the test runner, then we need to go for the complete programming. Suppose, sir, I have one more scenario. Is there, sir? Okay, write down second scenario. What is the second scenario? My second scenario is, this time I want to check with invalid data, sir. Okay, write down. My second scenario is, I am checking first feature is login functionality only. Second one, I need to go for login with invalid data. Scenario given is, yes, go to the navigation page. Now here, valid ID. Instead of valid ID, I can give my name. Then what it will happen if I enter using wrong ID? Is it successfully login? No, it will give error message. See madam, whatever up to now I am written, it's in the program language you written. Now I am written in some English language. That is nothing but a word, cucumber. Here, anyone can understand by using this. The main purpose is to maintain coordination between the business analyst, developer and a test engineer. If any problem is occurred in the domain, the organization, they can use this cucumber framework. Why? Because in the organizations, business mind is different and IT is the different. They don't always understand each other. Business will always thinking one different manager. Developer will think one different. Testing will different one thing. So that's why first I need to develop these feature files. Feature files are nothing but highly recommended to in cucumber. The main specification will be mentioned under that feature files. So in that Gherkin language, we are using common words are there, given, when, then, only these three are there. Given is nothing but a precondition, when is nothing but a user action, then is nothing but our output and result. Clear up to here? What is feature, what is scenario, given, when, then? So later I will see the multiple examples. Madam, clear?
Yes, Mahesh.
What, Neha? Yes. Now.
It is clear.
Yeah, okay, fine. Now, I will write this cucumber. Whatever I explained, I will write this here. First 1-2 classes only theory part is there. Once I installed cucumber, we can write there some program. So how to write this? First I'm writing in the notepad feature files. After that, these feature files where I can write, I can show in the cucumber. There are multiple jars are required. We can download the jars. We can add into program. In the Eclipse, same procedure. How we are configured Selenium, same like that we can configure cucumber also. Just 1 or 2 classes theory part is there. After that, we need to go for the practical work. So first of all, what is a cucumber? A cucumber is a tool. BDD tool. We can call it as here. Behavior driven development tool. Why we go for, we can use it. For web applications. So main thing, we can write the acceptance test cases. Is it understandable language to all the persons? We are using this cucumber tool. Behavior driven development means, at the time of development process in progress, we need to write these type of feature files. That is called as behavior driven development. So what is this cucumber means? It allows the automation of functional validation. So we are not writing any program here, just English language I'm writing, but we are thinking about the functional validation. Enter valid ID, enter invalid password, click on login button. So what it is happening is it allows our automation functional validations. In easily readable and understandable format. Like plain English. Just now I'm written now. So completely English language is there, nothing code. Why? Because to understanding purpose of BA, developer and test engineer understanding purpose, the maintaining team coordination between all these members, I can use this type of files. Those files are called as a feature files. These feature files can serve as a good documentation for all. Who are the all members? All that members, so BA, developer, test engineers. So there are some other tools also there, JBehave, and multiple tools are there. Same like that, Cucumber is also one of the. So first initially, where it was implemented in Ruby. Then it was extended to Java framework. So why we go for behavior driven? Up to now, whatever you are following in Selenium, that is test driven development. So the extension of that test driven development, we need to go for this behavior driven development. So that BDD is the extension of the TDD, test driven development. Why we are going for this? We have to test the entire system instead of a piece of code. From specification onwards, whereas in Selenium just we are writing scripting only, we are not writing about anything about the specifications. Orally I'm explaining scenario, write a program, Gmail login logout, okay, go to that package, right click, create a class, Gmail login logout, I'm writing the program. So where is the specifications? Nothing. But whereas here we need to perform entire testing of the system. Testing means from specifications I can write, coding I can write into one single environment. That environment is nothing but our behavior driven development. Both I can combine in a one format, one single place. So where we can use this cucumber? We have familiar idea about Selenium, so I can use Selenium with cucumber. One more tool is there, Ruby on Rails. In that also they can use cucumber. Pico container, they can use this cucumber. Spring framework is there, Java. they can use the cucumber. And one more is there, water. So like that, multiple tools they can use this cucumber. Why? Because anyone use the cucumber. All automation functionalities which is possible to automate, we can write all those into our cucumber. Like English language, we can write it. So what is the languages it will support? Which language it supports? First it is introduced by the Ruby. After that it is Java. It supports Ruby. It supports Gosu language, Lua, .NET, PHP, Python. But the most powerful is Cucumber with Java. But nowadays, Cucumber with Python is huge market is there. Yes. So first we need to go for the Cucumber with Java. After that, once I have the knowledge on Python, then I can implement Cucumber with Python. In your resume, if you keep one word, I have knowledge on Cucumber with Python, definitely your resume will be shortlisted. All my online student trainers, they are watching my website. They are asking, sir, when you are starting Cucumber, we will join like that. So I will start one batch morning 6 o'clock, early morning 6 o'clock, maybe 2-3 days after, I will start one new batch. All the guys that ready to this Cucumber. Why? Because nowadays, number one hotcake framework is Cucumber. In that, whatever you are writing, scripting a very easy, understandable language when compared with our Selenium also. Okay, then why Cucumber? What are the advantages are there? Why we go for the Cucumber? Right, because by using Cucumber, I can merge all the specifications and test documents into one place. So I can go through the English language, what is happening there, and I can add the test runner program. So as a technical people, they can understand. As a BA people, they can understand. As a developer, they can understand. Everyone can understand it. So the first one is, the Cucumber will merge specification documents and the test documents into one cohesive whole. Means one place we can write all these feature files and test run and everything. After that, in every domain, in every organization, technical team is the different, testing team is the different thinking, and BA people is the different. So always business and this IT, they don't understand each and everything. They don't know the each and every others. So what it will happen? Whatever the Cucumber executable specifications are there, those will be very closer collaboration with the team collaboration time. So always they can keep it in mind of our test engineers and developers, anything. They mainly maintaining collaboration between all the team members. So whatever I'm written, all these are automatically tested by the Cucumber. So that's why every specification should be up to date in the feature files. And main thing, it acts as a bridge between the business analyst people and our technical people. Why? Because it is a plain English text, so anyone can understand it. And it allows the test step, even zero knowledge on the programming, non-programmers also, they can write the test scripts in the Cucumber. So now second point is, they don't understand each and other. So Cucumber executable specifications encourage the collaboration all times. Why? Because all these are automatically tested by the cucumber, our specification documents. So every specification should be time to time updated. Whatever the new specifications are given. Suppose in case of the agile methodology, there is a product owner is there, scrum master is there, some team is there. In all these three bitwins, they can use this tool. Every specification whenever given by the client, it is collected by the product owner. He will add it into our specification documentation. So here, everything should be up to date or available in our future files. Specifications are always bang up to date. The main cucumber will act as a bridge between the business and the technical language. Can write all these test cases in a plain English text. And the main, these feature files are allowing without having any knowledge on the programming person. Any non-programming also, we can write the feature files. So what is the feature file? I will explain. Every time I am telling feature file, na. So all cucumber is rotating on that feature file only. That is nothing but specifications are available there. Without knowledge of any code, I can write the feature file. Non-programmers also, they can allow to write this. That's why we need to go for this cucumber part. So, to understand the cucumber, first we should have idea about the some keywords. What are the keywords at their feature file? In that feature file, future, scenario, what is the given, when and then. We need to aware about these five keywords. What is the future? What is the scenario? What is the given? What is the when and what is the then? See? First, I will explain those four keywords. After that, how to implement this in the coding, we will discuss. Just today, just I am giving about only the terminologies about the cucumber. So, in order to understand cucumber, we need to know all the features of cucumber and how to use that. Then we need to use the keywords feature. So first files we need to create it in cucumber, the basic files are called as feature files. This is the main file. Entire cucumber, the rotating between these feature file only. So what is the feature file? It contains the essential part of the cucumber which we are using to write the test automation steps. Whatever the automation test scripts are written, those scripts I can make it as a some specification part. That is called as a feature file. Which is used to write automation steps. Acceptance test. We can use as a live document. Why? Because based on this feature file only, my test run will execute. So whatever the steps I am written in the feature file, those are nothing but application specification. All the feature files should contain dot feature extension, just like notepad dot txt, excel dot xls, same like that. And with the dot feature extension, that is of the feature file. So how to create one sample feature file? Created. So first I need to declare one feature, the main keyword of that, that is contains one specification, means what we have to checking. So that is feature, followed by the colon. I need to check login functionality feature. I need to check. So to this login functionality, is it working or not? Means first in the feature file we can write in the English language. After that, we can write the test run, test runner, we can call it as A. So, in this, we need to mention scenario. What is scenario? What to test in the application? So, here I need to test login functionality with valid data I am checking. That is my scenario. So for that, what is the precondition means that is given. So first user open an URL. So user navigate to selenium.mahesh.com/hms.com. This you need to navigate. After that, whenever user entered a valid ID and valid password, user 1 and valid password user 1. What it will happen? That is comes under your then condition. Login should be successful. This is one sample feature file. Feature is nothing but one specification. Login functionality feature I am checking. In that multiple scenarios are there with valid data, with invalid data, I can check it. So in that given, when, then scenarios are there. I need to given, when, I need to then. What all these? We will write one by one, I will write. Suppose, sir, I want to check the invalid data. Okay. Create one more scenario. A feature contains multiple scenarios. One scenario contains multiple test cases in manual testing. Same thing here you need to follow. Login with this time invalid data. Given user navigate to Selenium compulsory. When? Okay, user enter some wrong ID. He has entered some Mahesh. then what it will happen? Login won't be accepted. It throws an error message. Error message should be. So that is one feature type. So here, what is the feature? What is the scenario? What is the given when? Now we can observe. Feature is nothing but it gives the information about the high level business functionality. And what is the purpose of our AUT? AUT means application under test. High level business functionality we need to check, and the purpose of AUT. AUT is nothing but application under test. That is called as one feature. So everybody should be able to understand what is the main intention of that feature when we can see that first line. So that is nothing but we can write some brief definition to our one future. By reading the just that feature step only enough. I don't want to read complete scenario. Just by seeing that first step in the future, I can get some idea. What is scenario? Scenario is nothing but what we have to test. I am checking login with valid data. I am checking with login with invalid data. I am checking login with without data. That is called as a scenario. Basically, a scenario presents a particular functionality which is under test. Means what to test in the application we can write under scenario. By seeing the scenario, whatever the user performing operations, everything should be identified. So what I can verify in first scenario with valid data, I can verify, or I can verify multiple data, I can verify invalid data. So by seeing that scenario, every user should be able to understand the intent behind the scenario. The test is all about that will be identified. Each scenario should follow given when then keywords. Each scenario should follow these keywords: given, when, then. Where they are taking this language is called as Gherkin language. Common used keywords, those are from that Gherkin language, they can given this given when then conditions. So what is the given? Given is nothing but precondition. When is nothing but whatever the user actions I want to perform, those actions I can mention in the when. Then is nothing but the expected output or results. You see, what is the teach and everything? First we need to go for given. Given specifies a precondition. It is basically a known state. When it contains user actions. When some actions to be performed. So in that above example, we have seen when user enter login username and password. An action. Right, because when contains whatever the user actions. In previous example, refund situation is there. In that refund, I am given condition is user should have the receipt. Second, whenever we can hand our receipt to the customer, he will use the mobile. So whatever the actions we are performing, that is under when. What is that then? Immediately in our mobile counter, they can increase on mobile. Automatically in our account, it will be created with money. So then is representing with the expected outcome or results. Should be placed in then. Example in the complete login should successful, error message in this then condition, there all the then, that is the future. Future contains the main specification, scenario contains what to test in the application, given is nothing but in that what is the precondition. And when is nothing but user action, then is nothing but the coming output. And along with that, there are some another keywords are there. Background, example, scenario outline, multiple conditions are there. But every scenario contains compulsory given, when, then. Based on the multiple examples, maybe sometimes I can go for the background. Background means one step is required to each and every scenario. I can make it as a background. Suppose I need to use the scenario outline. Scenario outline is nothing but if I want to test, here I am checking with only single value, user and user. I need to check the multiple values. I have 10 IDs and passwords are there. Then I need to go for the scenario outline. In that, I need to go for the examples, some tables, something is there. So the main important thing was, what is a feature file? Feature file is nothing but understandable common language to each and every person. Either suppose you can see, if I'm given this feature file to anybody as a BA, developer, tester, design architect, project manager, scrum master or product owner, they can able to understand it or not? Right, because here common language I'm written in English language I'm written, so everyone can be understandable language it is. After that, how to implement this? So can I execute this notepad anywhere? No. So this feature file I can write in Cucumber environment. After that, I can add one more file, that is test runner. Just like in our Eclipse, I'm creating, I can write the programming and I can execute it. So each and every step will be executed there. Then that is the next procedure, how to create the test runner files and how to combine this feature file and test runner. Why? Because the main purpose of Cucumber is this is. It will merge the specifications and the test documentation into one place. That purpose we need to go for the Cucumber. So the main keywords are future, scenario, given, when, then. Future is nothing but the basic information, scenario is nothing but what to test in the application, given is the precondition, when is the user action, then is the expected output and expected results. So first 1 or 2 days only theory part is there. Why? Because we should have familiar with these words now. When we go for given, what is the when, what is then. Once we should be familiar with this, we can write all the examples, any example. Suppose I want to log in Gmail. Okay. The given condition is open URL. When, enter username, password, then login page should be opened. Every scenario, whatever the problem is there, that problem we can written in a one common language, English language. After based on this feature file, I can implement my test runner methods and I can execute it. That is the procedure we can follow here in this Cucumber format. Up to here, clear? So again, there are some keywords are there: background, tag name, smoke test, and scenario outline. Some just 4 or 5 keywords are there. Once these keywords we are familiar, then how to implement all these into our Eclipse? Why? Because already in our machines, Java is available, Eclipse is available, Maven is available, everything is available. Simply we need to download the Cucumber jars and we can add here. After that, we need to explain how to create this feature file. Just I'm writing in the notepad, but we need to create this feature file into our Eclipse. Here I need to create our feature files. When we can get that, whenever I can insert Cucumber into successfully, see. In starting classes, I explained Selenium, how to create a project, go to file, click on new, click on your project, Java project. Same like the here also, go to file, new, but this is I'm using. Two types are there again, Cucumber with Java is there, Cucumber with Maven is there, both are there, both I will explain. Which one you can comfortable, you can use it. So from tomorrow also, some keywords are there. There are keywords like this, given, when, then. Scenario outline, one keyword is there. Tag one, key one is there. So multiple keywords are there. Once it is completed, day after tomorrow, I need to go for installation procedure of Cucumber with Java and with Maven. Both I can explain. After that, how to create these feature files into that Cucumber and how to write our test script and how to combine these two, I will explain. Clear? Neha?
Yes, sir.